Krishna, or Krish, is a blind piano player who unwittingly becomes embroiled in the murder of a retired actor. When I first heard that Anthakan was in the works, I couldn't help but roll my eyes. Yet another remake of Andhadhun. The thought alone was exhausting. I'd already seen the original 2018 Hindi film not once, but twice, and with the other two remakes hitting the screens in 2021, I felt like I was being asked to relive the same story for the fourth time. Despite my skepticism, I decided to approach this Tamil remake with an open mind. After all, it had been some time since I last immersed myself in the Andhadhun universe, and Anthakan had the potential to bring something new to the table. In some ways, it did, in others, not so much. One of the most notable aspects of Anthakan is its unwavering faithfulness to the original script. Director Thiyagarajan, who took over after multiple directorial changes, sticks closely to the blueprint laid out by Andhadhun. For fans of the original, this can be both a blessing and a curse. On the one hand, the story's brilliance remains intact. The clever twist and turn that made Andhadhun a gripping thriller are all present here. The camera work and sound design are commendable, with clever framing and auditory cues that play with the audience's perception, especially during scenes where Krishna's blindness comes into question. These elements are reminiscent of the original's brilliance, ensuring that Anthakan retains the core of what made its predecessor so engaging. But this faithfulness to the original also brings with it a sense of predictability. For those who have seen Andhadhun and its earlier remakes, there's little in Andhadhun that feels fresh or innovative. The film plays out like a well-rehearsed tune, familiar and comfortable, but lacking the spark of spontaneity. It's a well-executed cover of a classic song, but it doesn't dare to stray from the original composition. That being said, Anthakan does have its share of positive aspects. Simran's portrayal of Simi, originally played by Tabu, is a standout. She brings a level of sophistication and menace to the role that keeps you on the edge of your seat. Riya Anand as Julie also delivers a decent performance, and the supporting cast, though hit or miss, adds layers to the narrative. The cinematography is another highlight, with scenes that are visually engaging and contribute to the overall suspense. The way the camera captures Krishna's perspective adds an extra layer of tension, making you question what is real and what is part of the elaborate deception. The sound design is another area where Anthakan shines. The background score and sound effects are meticulously crafted to heighten the tension, and while the songs themselves might not be memorable, the way they are integrated into the film's narrative is clever. However, not everything about Andhadhun hits the right notes. Prashant, who plays the lead role of Krishna, feels miscast. At 51, he lacks the youthful charm and energy that the character demands. His performance, though competent, doesn't carry the same weight as Ayushman Khurrana's in the original. This miscasting is particularly glaring because the role of Krishna is central to the film's success. If the lead doesn't fully embody the character, the entire film feels off balance. The music, composed by the usually brilliant Santosh Narayanan, is another letdown. Given his track record, I expected more, especially after his work on Kalki 2898 AD. However, the songs in Andhadhun are lackluster and fail to resonate. For a film where the protagonist is a musician, this is a significant drawback. Moreover, the pacing of the film is uneven. The narrative, while faithful, feels flat at times. The tension that was palpable in Andhadhun is diluted here, and the twists don't pack the same punch. The dialogue penned by Pattukottai Prabhakar failed to evoke the emotional depth required to make the audience truly invest in Krishna's journey. Despite its flaws, Anthagan manages to carve out a space for itself among the Andhadhun remakes. It is, without a doubt, the best of the three remakes. While it may not surpass the original, it doesn't need to. Anthagan stands as a testament to the timelessness of the story it tells. It's a film that respects its source material while attempting to bring something new to the table, even if those efforts are not always successful. In conclusion, Anthagan is a good one-time watch, especially for those who haven't been overexposed to the Andhadhun and its adaptations. It may not offer much in terms of surprises for those familiar with the story, but it still provides an engaging cinematic experience. While it might not hit all the high notes, it's a film that deserves a chance to be heard. That's my opinion on Anthagan. Do you agree with my thoughts? What are your thoughts on the film? Let me know in the comments. Please drop a like and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in the next video. What did happen to the last 10? I ran away with my life, fast forward, never turned back again. It's kind of funny that the more we pass time, the more we need to set them rewind. And 19 was the year I had to leave you, but now I'm seeing all the signs. Is this